Is Logseq better than Workflowy? Well, that depends. I like to use different note apps to store information based on context. For example, I use Bare Notes as a day-to-day personal journal. I use Workflowy as a commonplace book with all of my go-to information, like when I had my last oil change, how my computer is configured, and best practices on a wide variety of topics. For researching my video ideas and writing scripts, I use Obsidian at work, and also for special projects at home, I use Logseq. In this video, we'll look at some of the features that really make it stand apart from Workflowy. Created a demo graph, which is basically a, think of it like your collection of notes or a folder on your computer where the notes would live. I have it synced with my iCloud, but you could choose a different folder, Dropbox, or even Logseq's sync service. So I wanted to start out with the feature called Journals because I really didn't get it when I first started using this app. There are so many different ways to customize this. It may look different for you because I've turned on some plugins for myself. There were so many customization options, I wasn't sure where to start. So I recommend starting with the journal and I'll show you why. Okay, so let's get started. Press open bracket, let's type in YouTube. And then press enter to create a new page, and then press enter again. The way notes work in Logseq is very much like Workflowy. Everything is in outliner format, so I automatically created a second bullet. I can press tab here. Let's go ahead and put, is Logseq better than Workflowy? And what this did is it allowed me to be able to store this information under the YouTube page automatically. Let's go ahead and create another example. We'll say coding with Swift UI. Press enter for a new page and then put like placeholder just for our notes to have here. And then we'll create another page here and we'll call it retro gaming. Then we'll press enter. And then here we'll put RG35XX is the best emulator console. So this was today, September 21st. I've installed a few plugins here, and there's one for a date picker, so you can see previous journal days. So let's go back in time, and we'll choose the 18th of September. Let's type in YouTube. And I'll type in a note, should I create a YouTube video about Logseq? Yes, so it should show the customization options. Tons of plugins to choose from. Should this be a series? Let me know in the comments. Okay, so let's go ahead and click on YouTube here. This is my project for YouTube. And down here is a section, and this is what made it really work for me, is it says two linked references. So we had that September 21st today, and we're talking about the title here, and so you can see my notes. And then on September 18th, 2025, you can also see my notes. For example, like at work, for me, and like my day job, this is great because I can put every project that I'm on or every meeting that I have as a separate page. And then as I take notes every day on those projects or on those meetings, they'll show up in the page like this, YouTube, with all of its references below. And for me, that really unlocked how to organize. This allows me to be able to tag things quickly. And speaking of tags, let's show that. Let's do video editing here, right? Press enter. It creates the new page for that. So what I can do here is I can say, should I edit? And then I can press hash and I can actually tag another page here, like in line, or I can do that search for a page and be able to link that way. But the tagging by doing hash is really cool. So I can do YouTube again. Should I edit a YouTube video later? Press enter. And then it has styling for that tag that's separate. And if I click on this, again, it's just the same link to a page for YouTube, but then it shows the additional context here of, oh, the video editing, go back to journals. You know, I can see this, should I edit YouTube video later? And since this is Markdown formatting, I can go in here and put in a heading of 3 So this would be like an H3. Or if I wanted bigger text, an H2, and that will automatically underline it. The page title itself is set kind of like an H1. But to show what that looks like, I can go ahead and style that accordingly. So you have some different heading variations here. And just like Obsidian, it has a slash menu. And here you can say heading, H2. Here you can say H2, you can say H1, and it'll replicate what we just did there, all the way to H5. And that mirrors how HTML puts headings on a page. So the journal is great because over time you can start to see which pages that you edit. And one of the plugins I like to use for that is this one here. So Total Journal Blocks. It gives you like the view that Git has to show you like a graph, like what's been filled in. Let's go ahead and take a look at the plugins that I have installed. So if we go to plugins, only have a few, but I can show you some others that I like. You know, here are the install plugins, here are the plugins in the marketplace. I've installed Todo, which actually shows you a to-do list on the page, and I can show you how those work in a bit. We have the journals calendar, which is what I showed you map, which I was talking about how that looks like GitHub. So under marketplace, you can sort these by downloads, stars, or titles. Stars is from GitHub, how many things have been starred, like the project. So I'll do downloads, which is the default. Journals calendar is really nice to see that. Some people use bullet threading. I like the tabs plugin too. I have another computer with that set up. The tags plugin allows you to be able to find and search all of your tags, which is nice. The markdown table editor is super useful. I use that all the time. I know people love the Readwise official plugin, which allows you to pull in your highlights from Readwise, which is really great. And as you can see, the plugins just go on and on, and it starts to be a little bit overwhelming. As far as the choices go, I'm going to go ahead and turn on Todo Exploder because it's one of my favorites. And let's go ahead and take a look at how to create to-dos. In this YouTube page or within a journal page too, it doesn't matter. You can type in Todo and say upload video to YouTube, Todo edit video before uploading. And the plugin that we just installed that allows you to have a confetti with the to-do if you mark that off. Confetti is just a nice touch to be able to have like a celebration of completing an item. So what does Logseq not have that Workflowy does? And I would really say mirroring is the biggest, for some reason, seems to be the feature that other Node apps can't seem to emulate as well. So I'll give you an example of how that might work here. So if we want to embed an older note, so let's go ahead and make a note for September 10th, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And let's go back to our journal footer today. And you know, with Workflowy, mirrors allow you to be able to have content in two different places at the same time. And if you make an edit in one of the places, then it allows you to see the edit somewhere else, like it's in real-time sync within your own notes. It kind of has it, but I don't like it in Logseq the way they've implemented it. So I can do block embed, and then I search for block. So let's search for Carmen Sandiego, and then it embeds that node that we created just a minute ago. And here's the reason I don't really like it. It's more like literally embedding the note within your page instead of having it live in both places at the same time. So I see this as like a window into that other note. So I can go in here and actually add a second note and say update this. And if I do go back to September 10th, it still is there. But the formatting for me just throws me off because I would like it to look the same in both places. Workflowy gets around this a little bit by indicating it with a diamond instead of a bullet. And that's how you know it's a mirror. With a block embed, it just feels like you're adding a snippet of another page into a page. And if that works for you, for like referencing quotes, if you're writing longer form content, then that makes sense. Overall, if you like using an outliner for notes, Logseq is a great tool. It's great for me for work because it can create local files that I don't have to sync with the cloud. It's great for me at home because I can use it to create certain projects that have their own set of notes, and it's really having that context of here's the notes that I want to keep within this folder. And I love the peace of mind that no matter if I put an image inside of Logseq, it'll be there and I know where it's at in the folder. Or if I right click on this and choose open in directory, I can see in Finder where the file lives as individual markdown files. For me, that's peace of mind. I can schedule this for a backup and know exactly where my notes are. They aren't stored in the cloud, but optionally they can be. So it's a really versatile tool. I highly recommend it. Personally, for me, I'll continue to use Workflow. It's a commonplace book for all of my go-to information, like maintenance on my car, how my computer is configured, best practices on a wide variety of topics. But for those one-off projects that I do want to store a lot of notes in, Logseq works for me. And be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos diving into tips on tech, productivity, retro gaming, and everything else in between. If you'd like to see how to control Workflowy with your Stream Deck, click on this video. See you on the next one.